Thanks for joining us. I'm Courtney Sanders. We begin with two schools, two grants, and one exciting outcome. Duval students branching out in STEM. We've got the back-to-back coverage. Here's Real School reporter Rishi Kumar with today's top story.
Hey Courtney, they're going from lectures to labs, from hearing about it to getting their hands on it. An experiment we know will yield amazing results. Welcome to Science in Action.
Now I'm gonna go to my...
They're recording growth, studying the human body, and taking a closer look at plant structures. From the brand new equipment, and even to the white coats, students say they couldn't imagine a better way to learn.
We just come to the science lab and like do more hands-on stuff.
This is the new science lab at St. Clair Evans Academy Elementary School. Much of what you see has been made possible by a $50,000 grant.
I'm excited about their excitement because when you help a student to understand the educational background and then allow them to have hands-on experience, it's great.
Funded through the Annenberg Foundation, teachers say that the school went from having just a few items to what they now consider a fully functional lab. 400 students now have access to microscopes, models, materials, and much more. It's everything they'll need to begin connecting their classroom experiences to careers.
It's really important for our students to be able to engage with jobs of the future. And one of the ways that they get engaged in that process is by them having experiences in science, technology, engineering, and math. And so in a school where students are not always exposed to those things at home, we have to make certain that we are heightening that exposure in the school building.
And once students were exposed to this new level of learning, leaders say it wasn't long before they noticed some significant changes.
They're catching on to our concepts much quicker because they're able to manipulate the materials.
They're asking more questions and their grades have improved because of that hands-on combination.
Wow, that's amazing.
Just learning about science is like good for us to try new things, just to learn more about it.
We think so too. But what's even more impressive is that students are beginning to see science, technology, engineering, and math under a new lens. One that includes their future.
It's actually exposing them to more experiences that they didn't have before. Now if you ask some of our kids, what do you want to be? Scientists is coming out. Computer engineering is coming out.
One thing's for sure, these students definitely have exploration in STEM down to a science. And they're having plenty of fun along the way.
It just warms my heart to see them love the learning. When they come in here, they're excited, they're having fun.
St. Clair Evans isn't the only school that received this grant. Reynolds Lane also received $50,000 last year. I can't wait to see what's next. For Real School, I'm Rishi Kumar. Back to you.
Thanks, Rishi. You can call it a school within a school, one that allows you to innovate with computers, robots, even items from the produce section. Real School anchor Will Nowak joins us now.
Courtney, after today, you may look at oranges, bananas, and other fruits a little bit differently. That's because in the world of STEM, even the simplest objects make for the greatest discovery. Sound familiar? That's Mary Had a Little Lamb. But forget using a keyboard. And hello, oranges. No, your eyes aren't playing tricks on you. This is a kit that allows students to use everyday objects like oranges and even bananas as touchpads. A unique invention soon to become the norm here at Northwestern Middle School.
We deserve a good program to help our students learn.
In a news conference held in the school's media center, district leaders made the exciting announcement. A $2.1 million school improvement grant from the Florida Department of Education will allow Northwestern Middle School to launch a computer science academy.
This is going to be a unique school, and it will be a destination for students at the middle school level.
That means students will soon work in facilities that look like this. They'll have access to equipment that looks like this. And they'll gain instruction that will result in these students and many more getting ahead in college and in careers.
When I think about an academy here at Northwestern Middle School, it is a game changer because we recognize that an academy first is a combination of education and workforce skills. It provides opportunities for our students to have pathways.
So what kinds of opportunities are we talking about? Well, how do coding, animation, gaming, and sound engineering sound to you? This new academy will provide specialized computer coding curriculum and project-based learning through laptops, robotics, computer science kits, and more. Students can become advanced coders before entering high school. Students not only see the immediate benefits,
I like video games and I love technology,
but they also understand the long-term implications.
To have a good career and go to a good college.
The impact of this academy will go far beyond this school. Once the academy is up and running, Northwestern Middle will be a hub serving 44 other STEM labs throughout the district.
It will mean that students that traditionally or over the past couple years have not gone to Northwestern will return to Northwestern. It means that students outside of Northwestern boundary that didn't think about going to Northwestern will come here only to have access to the tools, experience that will lead them to be more successful in high school.
As these students continue to innovate and stretch their knowledge of STEM, they say they can't wait to see what the future holds.
We must be pretty lucky.
You should know that students who go to St. Clair Evans Academy typically go on to attend Northwestern Middle. That means their understanding of STEM subjects will go from elementary to middle school and beyond. For Real School, I'm Will Nowak. Back to you.
Thanks, Will. In a history lesson come to life, our next story honors a civil rights icon with Jacksonville roots. You're looking at video of a celebration of James Weldon Johnson, organized by former state senator Tony Hill. Johnson was born here at the corner of West Adams and Lee Street in historic La Villa in 1871. It was the perfect place for dozens to gather and remember his life. Johnson is known for writing Lift Every Voice and Sing, which is commonly referred to as the Black American National Anthem. Students from James Weldon Johnson, La Villa School of the Arts, Young Men's Leadership Academy, and Stanton College Prep helped lead the crowd in a special rendition of the song. District 5 school board member Warren Jones says Johnson's life continues to inspire even today.
This place where he was born is a testament to what can happen for those of us who are born here in Jacksonville. No matter what the circumstances are, he rose above all the segregation, all the discrimination that existed in this city back then in 1871.
By the way, Johnson's many titles include lawyer, author, diplomat, leader with the NAACP, and principal of Stanton High School. What a wonderful way to honor a local hero. He shoots, and to everyone's surprise, he scores. Big time. We're introducing you to a third grade teacher with one slam dunk of a story, both on and off the basketball court. Real School reporter Madeline Stafford has the play-by-play.
Courtney, it's the case of the classroom meets the court. The basketball court, that is. It's amazing how things can change in just one shot. It's not unusual to find Kevin Nottingham shooting hoops here at Seabreeze Elementary. But what's unusual is this. That's the third grade math and science teacher front and center at the Jacksonville Giants basketball game. He was randomly selected to take a half-court shot for the chance to win a big prize.
Because I was a little nervous out there, I really was. You know, I was like, man, I don't want to airball this in front of my kids. I'll never hear the end of it. Don't airball, just hit rim is what I was just trying to tell myself. Just hit rim.
So, how did it go? Let's roll the footage. Wow, it's nothing but net and nothing but excitement as Nottingham swished that shot to the surprise of the energetic crowd.
I was just getting in the zone, and when I went and released, it kind of felt good, and then the outcome was all net.
It was really exciting, and it was like when I saw him, all the basketball players went over there. I was going crazy after that happened. I was shocked. I just had nothing to say about that.
$500 belongs to you. Give a big shout out. Congratulations, go!
So, you may be wondering how Nottingham and his class ended up at the game in the first place.
Awesome job.
He says for weeks, his students had been working really hard preparing for the FSA.
We're doing fractions, we're doing like these multiplication tests and division.
Going to the game would serve two purposes. One, to reward them for their hard work, and two, to show what teamwork and perseverance can accomplish.
Sometimes you're gonna be a little nervous or scared, but just go out there and just see what happens, really. And I mean, I've always told the kids, I mean, just go out there and just try your best. And you never know what could happen.
Nottingham never would have guessed that life would have handed him a teaching moment in the form of a basketball. And just like that, Nottingham showed his students the importance of giving it a shot, to learn to look fear in the face and never give up.
It taught me like you have to try and try again to make it. Sometimes he plays basketball outside, so I was like, oh, he keeps trying and trying, and then when he got to the game, he made it.
And guys, you'll never believe what else we learned. Nottingham not only made the shot, but he also did what no one else has.
The head person that does the PR for it, he was telling me, he's like, that you're actually the first to make it in that arena for a home game.
Congratulations, Mr. Nottingham. Way to make history and score one for the team.
Just don't be scared to fail. Just go out and just try your best. That's all I ever tell these kids, just try your best.
Would you believe a person chosen to take a half-court shot after Mr. Nottingham also made it? What are the odds? For Real School, I'm Madeline Stafford. Back to you.
Thanks, Madeline. They went around the world without leaving their school. Now we turn to a one-of-a-kind celebration at Reynolds Lane Elementary. They've got the beat all right. That's just a sample of some of the energetic performances put on by students at the school's multicultural festival. School leaders say this celebration was in many ways a collaboration that included students' clubs from Stanton and Englewood High Schools. And parents also stepped in by contributing their time and food for an international taste testing. Yum! Reynolds Lane Elementary is a center for English for speakers of other languages, or ESOL. Leaders say the goal of this celebration is not to only celebrate diversity, but to also ensure students of all backgrounds feel welcomed. The festivities continued with students participating in a number of activities. They made some really neat crafts and played games tied to specific cultures and countries. And boy, we can tell you they had lots of fun. Great job. Coming up on Real School, they're flipping the switch and turning the lights out, all in the name of literacy. After the break, you could say they're writing a new chapter in their love of reading. Keep watching to learn which elementary school is teaching their kids to bond over books. Plus, get on board and enjoy the ride. We're giving you the sights and sounds, a Discover Duval tour, complete with an in-classroom surprise you don't want to miss. We'll have these stories and more. Real School will be right back.
An exciting new dedicated magnet of visual and performing arts begins this fall at Fort Caroline Middle School. Distinctive and creative offerings in theater, dance, instrumental music, and visual and digital arts will enhance a strong academic foundation similar to La Villa. District-wide transportation is available, with enrollment open to all middle school students. For more, visit DuvalSchools.org.
Welcome back to Real School. The students in our next story are far from being in the dark. Instead, they're flipping the switch in order to shine a light on literacy. Let's go to Real School anchor Gracie Marsh for more.
Courtney, it's actually pretty exciting. Students at San Mateo are quickly going from buddies to bookworms, expanding their horizons one page at a time.
Mona jumped off the bus.
These are the sounds of students reading.
When she saw Janet.
Add a flashlight or two, and now you've got the sights and the sounds. On this day, this is what literacy looks like for students at San Mateo Elementary. Second and third graders are working in pairs.
We can get new friends and just read to other people.
But most importantly, they're learning from each other.
Because if you read more, then you'll know how to say words properly.
All new this school year, students at San Mateo are shining a light on literacy. It's something the school tried out in January during Celebrate Literacy Week. When teachers saw how much students enjoyed it, they decided to keep it going. And now, the plot just keeps getting better. Here's how it works. Older students are paired with younger students. They take turns reading to each other.
And it's just a good way to let them share their reading with each other and kind of show off what they've learned.
For an added element of fun, they turn the lights out and use flashlights to highlight each word. By the way, we hear the students really love using those flashlights.
It's really fun to read for me, and we get to turn off the lights and turn on our flashlights.
For teachers, this activity represents much more than just a page in a book. It's the story of how their students are developing a love for the written word, and they're sharpening skills like fluency and comprehension.
We want them to become people who want to read. And if that doesn't start young, and if they start having an opinion of reading that isn't positive, why would they take that and keep that as they grow up?
Students are having fun, all right, but they recognize there's more.
Because you can learn more words. It shows me more things what I can learn.
That's right. New words, new facts, and new experiences, all nestled in between the pages of these books and all from the comfort of their own classroom.
So I think whenever students are allowed to choose what book they read and what interests them, and even take that a step further and share that with someone else, they kind of take ownership of it. And then it's, you know, it's their choice to read that book, and it's their choice to share that book. And I think that's fun for them.
Now, even though you just saw second and third graders, this is a school-wide activity. All grades are participating. I think I'm ready to grab my own flashlight and curl up with a good book. For Real School, I'm Gracie Marsh. Back to you.
Thanks, Gracie. Now, over to Spring Park Elementary School. It's where students are turning over a new leaf, thanks to an exciting citywide initiative. The Tremendous Celebration kicked off with song as students led the gathering with a special performance. They're celebrating One Tree, One School. The goal of the initiative is to plant one tree at every single Duval County school. And, as you probably guessed, Spring Park was the first. One Tree, One School is a collaboration between the district, the city, Greenscape of Jacksonville, and Scenic Jacksonville. In fact, representatives from each group addressed the crowd, including board member and vice chair, Ashley Smith Juarez. All are eager to see the new venture take root and flourish in our schools.
This is a perfect project to make sure that all of you are involved, and it's such a great example because we all care about our city and making sure that it's a great place for all of you to live and to be. And so this is such a great way to work together to make sure that we're all doing something great for the city.
Those representatives didn't leave without grabbing a shovel and putting the finishing touches on this beautiful new tulip tree at Spring Park. Looks like our students had a blast helping out and hanging out with DJ. By the way, the funding for this initiative was authorized last year by City Council using money set aside specifically for planting trees. Nice work. It's an online sensation that took the World Wide Web by storm. And it was started by Duval students. We're talking about the Mannequin Challenge. And as Rural School's Jasmine Lowe reports, its creators are now going down in Jacksonville history.
Courtney, it's official. The Mannequin Challenge has gone from classroom to the web and now to a city council resolution. Welcome to Jacksonville City Hall. It's a place where council members aren't afraid to accept the challenge. The Mannequin Challenge, that is.
It was very exciting in the setting of City Hall and the atmosphere of the people around us embracing us.
But the story here isn't in these leaders striking a pose. It's really about these students. You see, they were the guests of honor, invited to City Hall to be recognized with a resolution.
It's kind of exciting and surprising at the same time because, I mean, we never thought we would be getting called from City Council, so it's just a humble experience.
These six students are the masterminds behind the Mannequin Challenge. They say it began as a spontaneous moment, one they thought would make a good art project.
The Mannequin Challenge started with Emily in class just going up to the board, being spontaneous, and Elena recording her and saying she looked like a mannequin, so I joined her and Jasmine joined her.
That moment evolved into a video, which they later posted on social media. It wasn't long before it became a sensation. People all over the world were accepting the challenge to stand still in a variety of different positions, just like mannequins.
It kind of blew up in like 2 to 3 days when a lot of people started reposting it and saying how cool it was. And then that's when it just took off and all schools and sports teams were doing it. And then I say like a couple weeks, 2-3 weeks, and then that's when celebrities and stuff started doing it.
Those celebrities include everyone from Beyonce to Ellen DeGeneres, sports teams like the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. Even former First Lady Michelle Obama got involved.
You kind of experience being a celebrity in a way because you kind of feel popular. So it's a great feeling to see everybody else redoing what we started.
So it shouldn't come as a surprise that Jacksonville City Council drafted this resolution, introduced by Councilmember Anna Brochet and co-sponsored by 6 other council members. It commends these students for their creativity, teamwork, and school spirit in coming up with the artistic performance.
It was very exciting. And then it was like, wow, all these people, they noticed us. They know where we come from. And we wondered how. But yeah, it was very exciting.
I don't think exciting even begins to describe it. And these students say they couldn't be more thrilled to leave a lasting legacy on the web, in their school, and in their community.
Finally, Ed White is looked at for something good and something that can change the community in a positive way.
It's good to finally see the news in a positive way instead of negative, and we can see students embracing each other and coming together as one.
And get this, the Mannequin Challenge has even been done by astronauts in outer space. Talk about out of this world. For Real School, I'm Jasmine Lowe. Back to you.
Thanks, Jasmine. They're stepping into character and traveling to new lands, all in a day's work. Coming up on Real School, meet the third grade teacher taking hands-on learning to a new level. Plus, it's a surprise she didn't see coming, but we did. Keep it here. Real School will be right back.
A. Philip Randolph Academies of Technology is combining high school academics with career-ready skills. This fall, new trade programs in high-growth industries will be available for students, including welding, electrical, plumbing, carpentry, HVAC, and more, preparing our students for college, career, and life every day. For more information, visit DuvalSchools.org.
Welcome back to Real School. From theater to music to dancing and to drawing, we've got tickets for a tour you don't want to miss. Welcome to Fort Caroline Middle School, the district's newest IB and visual performing arts magnet. Our cameras were rolling as dozens of leaders, parents, and community members participated in this Discover Duval School tour. The goal of Discover Duval is to give the public a chance to explore our schools and programs firsthand. Attendees walked the school and heard the band, observed a dance class, and watched theater students in action. But what made this tour even more exciting was this surprise. ELA teacher Karen Walrath was presented with a Public Education Strong Award of Educator Excellence by school board member Cheryl Grimes. The teacher of 20 years was given a beautiful bouquet of flowers, balloons, a plaque, and a gift card to Blackman. What a wonderful way to be recognized. Congratulations. Whether they're walking the plank or traveling to Neverland, the students in our final story are definitely on an adventure, and it's their teacher who's taking them on the ride. Today, we're going into her classroom and hearing her story in her own words.
Hi, my name is Jessica Atkinson, and I am a third grade ELA teacher here at Brookview Elementary.
Yes, we will capture the boys and make them walk the plank.
We've actually just finished reading Peter Pan, so my kids were kind of bringing it to life, and they had a script in their own character, and they were doing their fluency and building their comprehension by like really taking on the character and seeing how they could portray it. I think it's fun to just like really be your character. I think it's really engaging for them. You know, they have the hat, they feel like they're taking on that persona. I think if I'm talking at them the entire time, when they do anything, they're not gonna really take ownership of it themselves. So I think allowing them to be in charge of their learning is when they're really gonna process it and they're gonna be able to take so much more from it.
How can you bring that character to life? Think of some of the vocab we talked about.
I imagine that I would always stay in Jacksonville and end up teaching in Duval County. My mother was a teacher, and then my sister-in-law became a teacher, so I feel like it's always kind of been in my blood. And then when I was little, I used to, you know, line up all my dolls and play teacher in my room. So it's just always something I've had a passion for, and I just love watching my kids grow and seeing that light bulb go off really just gets me excited, and I feel like it gives me a purpose.
So here's what we're gonna do. You're actually gonna go back to your tables.
She does a fantastic job of really engaging her children and bringing her teaching to life. She does a lot of different techniques with her students to make sure that they are participating, that they're up, they're active, that they are doing a lot of the talking, and it's not just teacher directed, but really it's student focused.
Set her free immediately.
I feel proud that our students are able to act like that in front of each other and have the courage to stand up in front of their peers and their classmates and present something like that.
I'm seeing huge growth. My students are phenomenal at working together in teamwork. They're phenomenal at having the courage to read in front of each other and the courage to feel like they can accomplish anything that they set their mind to.
I think what makes a good teacher is the passion for it, and they love to see students' successes. I look at data each month, and Ms. Atkinson's class in specific has grown the most on Achieve 3000 in the grade levels. Ms. Atkinson by far has the highest growth this year with her students, so she's doing a phenomenal job.
Group one, you're gonna line up right here with your books.
There are other days when I'm kind of like, you know, I don't know what I'm gonna do, or this is so stressful, or something goes away I didn't really plan for it, but when I have those moments when I'm grading something and a student showed growth on that, that kind of gives me that boost.
Thank you.
It gives me like a purpose. I feel like I'm making a difference in my community and I'm making a difference in my kids' lives, and it just makes me so proud to see when they can accomplish something that I've helped them with and that they're going to take it on to their next grade level and their next school and hopefully onto their own career.
And some exciting news for Ms. Atkinson. She's celebrating a new title, Mrs. That's right. Miss Atkinson is now a newlywed with a new last name, Mrs. Daniel. From all of us at Real School, congratulations. That's it for this episode of Real School, but keep it here. We'll be back before you know it. A new episode debuts Sunday, May 7th at 6 p.m. right here on the CW. And of course, you can always do a season catch-up by visiting DuvalSchools.org. Till then, thanks so much for watching and have a great day.
And get this, the Mannequin Challenge has even been done in outer space by astronauts.
Courtney, it's a case of the best.
An experiment we know will yield amazing results.